Yeah, by car, Mom. Do you ever try and see things from someone else's perspective? Holy shit.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive.
No, holy shit, it's so ugly.
Dust is back.
I'll get a vacuum. Okay. Steve, I want to show you a room. Come on.
A playroom. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
He set up all my games.
Just for you?
Why do we have to keep all these creepy paintings and old stuff?
Well, they came with the house. Probably get rid of most of it. Yeah, this will cheer you up.
Stevie, come on. Coming. Yes, all our stuff.
Yay, belongings.
I thought you'd be pleased.
Yeah, you know nothing about me, Mom.
Ellie, you might like this room. Follow me.
Come on.
You know, when I was a kid, I would have loved to have lived in a place like this.
What's in there?
It's the cellar. Why don't you check it out?
It's filthy.
I like to think of it as character.
Yeah. Nothing to see here.
Get me out.
There's something wrong with the lock.
Come on, not funny.
Hang on, Ellie.
Dad, come on. Mom, Dad, get me out!
Okay, just wait. Calm down, okay?
Get me out!
Brian, there's a key.
Look
right there. There's a key.
Come on! Mom!
Yeah, we got the key. Just a minute.
Get me out!
Hang on.
Guys, come on! Mom! Get me out! I'm not staying in this house.
That's weird.
You okay? Can I come in? Listen, I wanted to ask your opinion about something. What does this make you think of?
Absolutely nothing.
What, do they look like they're having fun?
They look like brainwashed sheep. Come on, Mom. Are you in focus groups for this sort of thing?
Well, I wanted your perspective.
I hate your job, Mom.
Okay. Listen, I need you to watch Steven tonight. We have to go into the office, but we won't be late, I promise.
So you're leaving us here on our first night?
Come on, Ellie. This one's a big deal. This one's important, okay?
Fine. Why do we have to move here, Mom?
I'm doing this for you guys, so you have a better
no,
life.
No, you're not. You're doing it for yourself. Says they need it to survive. I hope they go bust and we have to sell the house.
Come on, Ellie. Maybe it won't be that bad.
I don't know. I just miss everyone. I miss you.
Why don't you come and hang out?
I could come stay with you.
Yeah. Why don't you?
Just a minute.
You okay?
It's nothing. I'm gonna kill you.
This is Sophie, 19-year-old vlogger, influencer. She's living a jet-set lifestyle, except she's not. She's an actress, and we plan to present her as a real vlogger with a real-life narrative. Now, these are some of the initial ads which we will run on all social media platforms to support the video content.
You changed the color of her bracelet?
Oh. We thought it was too...
Change it back.
I can think.
I got it. Ellie, what's up?
Mom, Steven keeps messing. He won't stay in bed.
Put him on the phone.
Hello?
Steven, come on, behave.
Otherwise, you'll be sorry for a week.
Okay.
So the target audience is pretty self-explanatory, 16 to 19-year-olds.
Would I miss?
Hello?
this demographic, teenage girls, they respond well to aspirational marketing and social competition. So can we create a weekly vlogging chart where vloggers compete to receive the most likes?
Who's the prettiest? Who gets the guy?
Natural selection.
Law of the jungle.
No, we call the competition natural selection.
Nice.
Ellie! The bottom, okay? Can you see the pillar in front of you?
11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Bye.
Linear.
What's going on?
She's run away again.
Right. She's done this before.
Yeah. She'll turn up after a few days at Fran's house. Why don't you go inside and play?
She was right.
About what?
When she said I didn't know who she was anymore. She's grown up and we haven't even noticed.
No, she's still a little girl to me.
There's no way she ran away.
She was angry, you know, she was upset with us.
You didn't hear her voice. Counting. Hello. Oh, I'm so sorry. I totally forgot. I'll be right there. I'm sorry, Steven. I completely forgot.
Did Ellie come back?
No. Not yet.
We've talked to our friends. We've pulled CCTV from every bus and train station, but no leads, unfortunately. We've checked her social media history, and there's a lot of harassment. Quite nasty bullying. Did she mention this to you?
No.
Well, don't worry, she gave as good as she got.
She didn't run away.
Why do you say that?
Something happened in the cellar. I heard her voice. It was... She didn't sound right. Have you tracked her cell phone?
Her phone pinged off the Three Rock mast at 8:42 p.m.
That was me. I talked to her. Could you just... Please... Check the house again, where I last talked to her in the cellar, for clues, anything.
I can come up and take a look again if you want.
What about specialists? Forensics?
It's not a criminal case. I'm really sorry. paint, plant-based, so the chlorophyll shows up as red under the UV light. It's very old, it's been there since the 50s, maybe. Do you know anything about the house's history?
No, we bought it at an auction. Yeah. House and contents, got it for nothing. Couldn't really turn down that kind of opportunity for the kids. So. I think it might have been an elderly lady who needed to make a quick sale for nursing home costs.
Well, the team haven't found anything else that would give us cause for concern. I'm afraid that's all we can do for tonight. I'll follow up with you in the morning. I promise you we're doing everything we can.
Thanks. I'll show you out.
I wet the bed.
It's okay. Come on. Let's get you changed.
Okay. What happened to Ellie?
I don't know, Stephen. But whatever did happen to her, I promise you that we will do everything in our power to get her back, okay?
Probably when I'm home.
all night?
I couldn't sleep. What is that? What does it mean? Have you thought about it? There's these symbols above all the doors. And they're different, but they're similar, right? And this is on the floor, in the cellar. It's some kind of mathematical equation.
We're gonna get her back, okay? We are.
She was being bullied. On her social media. We didn't even notice. It's because of me they think she's a fraud. They don't agree with what she stands for. Just because she's different. Doesn't want to follow the pack, I swear. Those bitches...
I know. All we can do is we support her, okay? But it makes sense why she ran away. It does. I just wish she could have talked to us, but...
I know, I feel so useless. I want to do something, but I don't know what.
She's definitely coming back. Yeah. I'm going to have to win today. Yeah, they love the pitch. They want to meet. Last thing we need is the business going under and us losing everything.
Rob Clayton?
Rob, it's Kira Woods from the auction.
You'll have to be a bit more specific, I'm afraid.
We bought the Kaus property.
Yes. What can I do for Kira?
We're having some problems with the house. I was wondering if you had any information on the previous owner.
Not much. She's the daughter of a well-known academic who owned the house originally.
Do you have a name or a contact?
We only dealt with her solicitor, I'm afraid. But leave it with me.
Okay, thank you. Erica, I need a favor. Shoot. Oh, I sent you an email. Can you find out what font or language these are and what they mean?
Yeah, they look familiar. They go with me.
Great.
We're talking about target demographics. 16 to 19-year-olds with focus on leaving cert students.
Congratulations. We just... loved your natural selection campaign.
Thank you.
We had a similar campaign go viral last year with the hashtag Follow Your Heart.
A wonderful campaign. We really liked the simplicity of the competition.
Simplicity is key.
Can't remember who said it. And I am paraphrasing, but... the receptivity of the great masses is very limited. Their intelligence is small. The power of forgetting is small.
He had to work late. What happened to your face? Let me see.
Morgan said Ellie was dead, so I hit him, and he hit me back.
Why are you doing that? Counting.
Was I?
I thought you were playing your game.
Me? Yeah.
Steven? Steven?
Mom, help!
Steven? What are you doing in there?
Help, I'm stuck!
Just a second. Okay, I'm right here. Hang on a second. Wait. Steven? Do you have the key?
No.
The lock is jammed.
It's dark, Mom, I'm scared.
Hang on, I'm right here, okay? I'm just outside.
Sleep in the playroom.
It's all right. Okay.
What's happening?
I thought I heard something.
Shh. Don't. Steven!
It's stuck. I can't get it open.
Steven! Start pulling on the door!
Rita, I need to get a chair.
Hurry up.
Sleep. Finally. What happened, Kay?
The lights went out. I got stuck in the cellar. There was something in there.
Something?
Yeah, I heard something. It was in there with me. A presence. Take a look. I dropped my phone. It fell down the steps. It's not there anymore. It disappeared.
I'm sure your phone is still there.
I also found out about the family that used to live here. The Featherstons. They all went missing. All of them except their daughter. Missing, Brian. Just like Ellie.
What are you trying to tell me?
I don't know. I just know that our daughter is missing and something very wrong is happening in the place that she disappeared.
Okay. I'm gonna go look for your phone.
Who are you?
Kira Woods. I made an appointment with...
What can I do for you?
Where did you get this?
I bought John Featherston's family home. It was engraved on the floor in the cellar.
Delta point vector sum epsilon partial I equals 1 n dy by dx. Call me Remy, please. Still haven't got used to this whole doctor thing. You see, I was in a car crash and banged to the head. Changed the parts of my brain we don't usually use and, well, now I'm a bloody genius.
How does that work?
Well, before the accident, I could barely add double numbers. But afterwards, I began to understand the language of mathematics. I began to see patterns in everything and somehow make sense of the universe. That's my magic trick. I'm able to visualize mathematical structures. That's pi, that's Hawking radiation, and that's a quantum star.
was he? Featherston.
Well, you're standing in his old office. He was a colleague of Erwin Schrödinger, Nobel Prize winner.
Cat in the box.
Yes, the cat.
Yeah, I never understood it.
It's simply his way of illustrating the misrepresentation of having quantum particles existing in two states. The cat in the box is either dead or alive. We can't tell until we open the box to observe it. So until we do so, the cat is both dead and alive. I'm sorry, did I say something?
No, no. My daughter is missing, so.
I'm very sorry to hear that.
Please continue.
Schrödinger came to Ireland in the 40s to escape the Nazis and work on his unified field theory here. Featherstone worked closely with him until his son became ill and he disappeared from academic circles.
Completely disappeared? I mean, does anyone know what happened to him?
No, it's a mystery. He has a daughter, Rose, who he must have purchased the house from. I don't think she ever recovered. She never really spoke about what happened. I can't quite visualize this yet, but at first glance, your problem, your equation, is definitely a representation for a dimension, or dimensions. There seems to be one variable that's interchangeable for each dimension. I'll be honest, it's incredibly complex and like nothing I've ever seen before. Can you leave it with me? Well, I'll come back to you.
That would be great. Thank you. Hello, Kira Woods.
Kira, it's Remy Frenet here. Is everything okay?
Yes, why?
I called you a few times and...
Oh, you know, I lost my phone. I just managed to replace it now.
That's strange. Someone answered.
What did they say?
It was counting. 11, 12, 13. I wasn't sure if you were okay or what was going on. Kira?
No, I'm okay.
Well, I want to let you know that I spoke to a colleague of mine in France about your equation, and he seems to think it's related to a branch of mathematics that was created by alchemists in the 12th century. He likened it to more of an incomplete sequence or an unfinished incantation. It's a very peculiar sequence, and it does seem to refer to dimensions, but it's incomplete, as I said. I'm sorry, I can't be of more help.
Well, thank you for looking into it for me.
There is one other piece of information. My colleague has come across a similar one, engraved in a house in Belgium. An infamous house, actually, where a family went missing. Vanished into thin air. Kira. Kira.
Steve, I'm gonna go talk to Mom.
Okay.
I've emailed these to you. These are the engravings above the door. They're Hebrew. They mean Leviathan. Like I said, I don't know what these triangles represent, but the letters, this is what they mean. Look what it says. The abyss. Featherston, the man who owned the place, he called it Chaos, Greek for chaos, the void before time, the abyss.
You're making huge leaps and connections between things that are completely unrelated. I could tell you that your name, Kira, in Greek, means Dark Lord, and that you're connected to all this.
That's ridiculous.
Is it? It also means dark-haired. You get my point? Look, the guy who owned this house was an obsessed academic. All of this, it's decorative. Doesn't mean anything.
You know better than anyone that everything has a meaning. Every image, every word is doing something. These are pieces in a puzzle. Can't you see that?
So what are you suggesting? What do all these symbols mean?
I don't know yet. I gotta show you something. Look, you see? Each step is numbered, 1 to 10. All right, what about this? Look. Thinks it's a formula to a different dimension, another place, Brian.
Here. This is delusional thinking.
This same equation was found in another home in Belgium, where another family went missing. This is our way to get her back, I know it. Please, Brian, I need your help.
Hi, Kira. Rob Clayton here. I've tracked down Rose Featherston. She's in a private nursing home called St. Anthony's. I'll put you in touch with her carer, Ruth Collins.
Rose agreed to it. She's inside. She finds it peaceful here. She doesn't speak much.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello, Rose. It's nice to meet you. I'm Kira. My family moved into your house. And now my daughter is missing. I came here to ask you about your father. And about the cellar. I know you've lost your family. I know what that's like. I've lost my daughter. So if there's something that you know, will you please, please tell me? Leviathan. Yes.
One of the seven princes of hell.
What is it?
That isn't its name.
Whose name? Rose, tell me.
My father brought it into our world.
Your father? He was a scientist.
He was. Until my brother Jack got sick and science couldn't help him.
Please take your time.
Mathematics are supposed to make sense of the universe. To make order from chaos. But all he succeeded in doing was bringing darkness into the world. A darkness that has existed since before the universe began. Something ancient. Something that has been known by many names.
Where is my daughter? She's still in the cellar.
It's not just the cellar. It's the whole house.
These are the shapes from over the doors. Okay? Five acute triangles. And a pentagon. there's more. Leviathan. The sea serpent is misdirection. These are the Hebrew glyphs. Over the 5 points. Sort of demon that the occultists and the Knights Templar worshipped. Some sort of gatekeeper or soldier in hell.
An ancient evil.
Look at the fingers. Just like in the painting. And there.
Salve Coagula. This whole house is being designed around it. Schrodinger's cat. That's Ellie. Neither dead nor alive until we find her.
Delta. Point vector.
What's that?
Sum. Epsilon. Partial 1 equals 1n.
That's the mathematical equation on the cellar floor. I'm positive it's Featherstone. He's reading it out loud.
But what does that mean?
I think it opens the box.
I'm thirsty.
I'll get him some water.
Yeah. Tell me, Stephen, did you see Ellie?
I don't know. I can't remember.
It's okay, I'm sorry. You're so hot. Here, let me take this off.
What is it? I remember.
What do you remember?
I rode the beast with 7 heads and 10 horns.
Thank you.
Ellie, it's Mom!